Hi friends, welcome to the Lewis Jarvis Show. I'm your host, LJ Jarvis, and welcome to this brand new episode. And guys, I gotta say, it's great to be back on YouTube. I took the necessary break that I need, but now I'm back to make videos about the hobby that I'm most passionate about. And that is, of course, being about all things Warhammer. Now to get us out of the way, I think 2020 looks like it'll be a great year for Games Workshop, because the Sisters of Battle are finally going to be available for pre-order. So I am really, really excited for this. I've been waiting for them throughout the whole year of 2019, and now that they're finally available to pre-order, I'm excited. And of course, I'm going to make a video just about me talking about why I love these new Sisters of Battle. I just can't wait to get the models, I can't wait to get the codex, I can't wait to start making a lore video about them. It's going to be a whole lot of fun, and I just can't wait. However, for today's video, I thought about discussing with you guys a brand new model that I'm looking forward to from Games Workshop, and some few other products. If you guys have followed my channel, you would know that I am a fan of the Tau. And if you've been paying attention to what's been going on by Games Workshop through their Warhammer community website, you'll know that Commander Shadowsun will be getting a brand new model. And just seeing the model, guys, it looks great. Like, Shadowsun is one of those models that desperately needed an update. Like, comparing her model to the quality of today's models, you can obviously tell that it's outdated, and it desperately needed an update. So I just think it was very cool that Games Workshop has finally given her a new model. Just seeing it, guys, it looks great. And funny enough, I kind of always imagined Shadowsun's new model being look almost something like a ghost kill. So the fact that it looks almost the size as one, that's pretty amazing. Like, there's nothing wrong I can really say anything about the model. All I can say is that it's beautiful, and of course, I'm going to buy it for my Tau. And if you watch my older videos, and if you saw my now-deleted video showing off my Tau army, you'll know that I have the Farsight Enclaves. For here, I won't paint her in the Farsight red. I'm going to keep her in the Stormtrooper white color scheme that she has going on. I'll just add her to my collection because I have to get her. I'm a fan of the Tau, and the fact that they're getting some spotlight for Psychic Awakening is pretty exciting. Funny enough, when I heard news that the Tau would get some spotlight in the Psychic Awakening book, I kind of imagined that it would be Farsight that would get a new model. The reason for that being that Mephiston, when he got an update model for Psychic Awakening, his second book came out at the same time. And because Farsight's second book, Empire of Lies, will also be available in February, the same time that the Tau would get their spotlight in Psychic Awakening, I kind of imagined that it would be Farsight that would get the updated model. Now, it's not a problem that he didn't get one, at least right now. And I don't really mind that it was Shadowsun that got the updated model, because after all, whereas Farsight got a new model, yes, it's fine cast, but it's an update from what he got from, say, 4th edition. Shadowsun's model, the first model, has always been the same. Like, there wasn't a new model for her, ever. Maybe later Farsight can get his new model. But right now, I am so appreciative that Tau characters are gaining some spotlight, like I've said a million times. And it's pretty cool that it'll be Shadowsun. So, I'm excited for that, of course. And this whole release has actually wowed me enough to start collecting the Psychic Awakening books again. Because, as you would know, I found the first book, Phoenix Rising, to be a little bit disappointing, and I just didn't bother getting Faith and Fury and Blood of Baal on the day of the release. But now that this has happened, it has wowed me enough to start getting the books. And going back on our previous topic about Farsight, as you guys might know already, Farsight's second book, Empire of Lies, will also be available in February. And that's very cool news indeed, because I've read Crisis of Faith, and I really enjoyed seeing the perspective of the Tau Empire and how characters like Farsight see the Imperium of Man as a whole. In general, I find 40k books that are kind of like that to be interesting, where we see the perspective of the Xenos races and how they see the Imperium of Man and how they see the whole war in 40k as a whole. I really like when Games Workshop does this, and the first Farsight book has been great. I've been wishing for a second one for a little while now, and it's very cool that they're going to continue his story. Again, I'm excited for it, and of course, I'm going to buy it alongside with the new Shadowsun model and the next Psychic Awakening book. Overall, 2020 so far has been spectacular. Like, the Sisters of Battle, again, are finally going to be available to pre-order, and it's really cool to see some spotlight on the Tau Empire, one of my second favorite factions in 40k. So overall, I would like to hear your views and opinions on Shadowsun and her new model. Do you like it, or do you have some criticism towards the model? And overall, what do you think about the spotlight so far on the Tau Empire? I would love to hear your views and opinions and comments down below. And in general, I would like to hear your ideas about how Games Workshop could expand the Tau Empire. Anyways, that's all I have to say for now. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week. And if you like this video and you would like to subscribe, then make sure to activate the bell notification button so you'll never miss an episode. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and I'll see you again soon.